This hand is better. We'll lead off with Sacred Foundry, followed by Kargan Dragonlord, double level. And then if we can spike a third mountain, that would be pretty good. It would increase our effectiveness. So we're gonna, we'd like to mulligan a five? No, he's kept, so we're off with our Sacred Foundry. Off to the races. Looks like we're playing against white, so we may want to sideboard appropriately for that. All right, so our turn. Tangle Wire. Well, we'll go ahead and get this bad puppy into play. We might want to consider playing Tangle Wire next turn, depending on what our opponent leads off with. And it appears to be a Near Heath Pilgrim. Well, that's certainly something. Rift Bolt. I think what I'm going to do is just level and ship the turn after playing a land. Then next turn we can suspend and play Tanglewire if we spike a land, or we can play Chandra. But I really don't want to just suspend Rift Bolt and then have him not play something and then me have to kill this when I have Chandra. I don't mind if he... Yeah, okay. This is the unfortunate potential outcome. Let's see. So he's going to gain some life, which sucks. And Jackal Pop, so it hasn't really helped us too much. I think what we can do now is just Rift Bolt his Silverblade Paladin. And then pass the turn after attacking. Fortunately, we couldn't spike a land there. Really would have liked to do that. This plant is pretty problematic for us. And he's going to go ahead and cast an Ajani Vengeant. It's not great. We really need to draw land here. Come on, top deck. That's unreal. All right, well, here we go. He's going to lock down our Sacred Foundry. So we can Frenzied Goblin one thing, and hopefully that ends up being okay. This game is quickly spiraling out of control. Not having access to that fourth crucial land. So we'll just have to wait and see what he plays here. We can Frenzied Goblin whatever he plays, then attack with both with Ajani. Baneslayer Angel. That's kind of ugly. Let's see if he attacks. And I do not think you're attacking. That is... Well, he's got a Baneslayer, so we need to draw some stuff. Mogwai War Marshal. Not really going to do it. So let's attack Ajani. You can't block. Body Yield. Pay red. Still be screwed because he's a Baneslayer Angel. This is not really fair. Look at this. This is too much lifelink here. I think we're going to go big for next match. I have a feeling that we need to play a bigger game. Because he's got a little bit too much lifelink for this to work out, I think. So we're down to five, and he's got a Baneslayer. So we need to draw... Can't actually draw anything. Revel Arc. Okay. So, what exactly do we want to do? We can play Elesh Norn. We can play Earthquake. Rolling Earthquake. Rolling Earthquake is especially good against his Flyers. And let's see, what else can we do? We can play Student of Warfare, maybe. Potentially Flicker Wisp. What are the bad cards? Bad cards include Goblin Cadets, Frenzied Goblin, Keldon Marauders, Warden Cunning Spark Mage, Student Warfare. We play Slagstorm also. Slagstorm's probably a little on the excessive side. Just go for more burn. And Jackal Pup's probably mediocre. Ranger gets really bad in this case. But we do have Student of Warfare, so it's not that bad. So if we leave the Jackal Pup and Spike Shot Elder in play, then that's better. But those are really bad with Rolling Earthquake, Earthquake, and Slagstorm. So we could just take. See what happens if we take out all our one drops. That might work out. Seal of Cleansing. Let's see. No, that's not going to work out. So at this point, we can probably board up another land, maybe? 17 lands or 18 lands. We do have the Tech Edge. So we could board in the Flicker Wisp. We've got one more to board out, though. So at this point, I think Tanglewire is probably the worst. So that's something to consider. Sure, let's. We are on a play, so we could. Might be able to run him over. Just on a draw, I just don't see that being very realistic. So, yeah, let's go ahead and give this a try. We'll give it a try on the draw.